What's up, bro?
Dad.
My mic on.
Is your mic on?
Yeah. Ready to rock. All right, sisters, y'all cover your head. About to stand to face Jerusalem and open up.
Blessed is the man.
Blessed is the man.
That walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly.
That walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly.
Nor standeth in the way of sinners.
Nor standeth in the way of sinners.
Nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful.
Nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful.
But his delight is in the law of the Lord.
But his delight is in the law of the Lord.
And in his law doth he meditate day and night.
And in his law doth he meditate day and night.
The ungodly are not so.
The ungodly are not so.
But are like the chaff which the wind driveth away.
But are like the chaff which the wind driveth away.
Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment.
The ungodly shall not stand in the judgment.
Nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous.
Nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous.
For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous.
For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous.
But the way of the ungodly shall perish.
But the way of the ungodly shall perish.
I just read to you Psalms chapter 1. Verses 1 through 2 and verses 4 through 6. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. I'd like to welcome everybody here to the Church of Israel. Everybody streaming with us live, YouTube, Facebook, and everybody that's in house with us today on the Lord's Sabbath day. We're going to start by reading our local, statewide, nationwide, and our international members today, because we're not just here, we all over the world. And we doing work all over the world, so praise God for that. We're gonna start reading off the names in the cities and the counties and countries right now.
All right, we're coming from Mobile, Alabama, Roanoke, Alabama, Maricopa, Arizona, Mesa, Arizona, Tucson, Arizona.
They want you at the table right now.
All right, are we start? We're in Mobile, Alabama.
His mic ain't on.
Turn it on.
Turn it on.
It's not that on.
And then start from the top, bro. Right.
Apologies. We're coming from Mobile, Alabama, Roanoke, Alabama, Maricopa, Arizona, Mesa, Arizona, Tucson, Arizona. We're coming from Little Rock, Arkansas, Tarks, forgive me if I mispronounce any of these, Tarksacana, Arkansas, I was close, Memphis, Arkansas, West Memphis, Arkansas, Antioch, California, Banning, California, Bellflower, California, California City, California, Compton, California, El Cajon, California, Fresno, California, Fullerton, California, Inglewood, California, Lathrop, California, Oakland, California, Oxnard, California, Rancho Cordova, California, Rockland, California, Sacramento, California, Stockton, California, Vallejo, California, Victorville, California, Visalia, California. I'm not sure if I said that right. Castle Rock, Colorado, Red Feather Lakes, Colorado, New Britain, Connecticut, Woodstock, Northeast Connecticut. We're also coming from Smyrna, Delaware, Gainesville, Florida, Hawthorne, Florida, Jacksonville, Florida, Miami, Florida, Orlando, Florida, though no to, I can't even say this, though no to Sasa, Florida.
Praise God. Come on.
Athens, Georgia, Atlanta, Georgia, Decatur, Georgia, Douglasville, Georgia, Lithonia, Georgia, Locust Grove, Georgia, Marietta, Georgia, McDonough, Georgia, Palm Bay, Georgia, Robbins, Georgia, and Tenino, Georgia. We're also coming from Aurora, Illinois, Bellwood, Illinois, Evanston, Illinois, Forest Park, Illinois, Lansing, Illinois, Mel Park, Illinois, Montgomery, Illinois, North Lake, Illinois, Oak Park, Illinois, Palos Hills, Illinois, Waukegan, Illinois, and Woodridge, Illinois. We're also coming from Overland Park, Kansas, Wichita, Kansas, Franklin, Kentucky, Louisville, Kentucky, Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Baltimore, Maryland, Germantown, Maryland, Green Belt, Maryland, Prince Frederick, Maryland, Silver Spring, Maryland. We're also coming from Brockton, Massachusetts, Dorchester, Massachusetts, Newton, Massachusetts, Mattapan, Massachusetts, Reverie, Massachusetts. We're also coming from Caledonia, Michigan, Flint, Michigan, Duluth, Minnesota, Minneapolis, Minnesota, St. Paul, Minnesota. We're also coming from Hattiesburg, Mississippi, Hazelwood, Missouri, Las Vegas, Nevada, Elizabeth, New Jersey, Newark, New Jersey, Albuquerque, New Mexico, Elridge, New Mexico, Rio Rancho, New Mexico. We're also coming from Latham, New York, Orange County, New York, New York, New York, Queens, New York, Selden, New York, Southampton, New York, Syracuse, New York, Warwick, New York, and Webster, New York. Also coming from Castlehaine, North Carolina, Charlotte, North Carolina, Durham, North Carolina, Fayetteville, North Carolina, Hollister, North Carolina, Morganton, North Carolina, Raleigh, North Carolina, and Statesville, North Carolina. Brooklyn, Ohio, Columbus, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, Holland, Ohio, Westerville, Ohio, Whitehall, Ohio, and Woodmere, Ohio. Also coming from Edmond, Oklahoma, Elizabethtown, Pennsylvania, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. We're also coming from Dillon, South Carolina, Eastleigh, South Carolina, and Greer, South Carolina. Clarksville, Tennessee, Hendersonville, Tennessee, Knoxville, Tennessee, Nashville, Tennessee. We're coming from Abilene, Texas, Addison, Texas, Arlington, Texas, Bryan, Texas, College Station, Texas, Dallas, Texas, Denton, Texas, Fort Worth, Texas, Grand Prairie, Texas, Houston, Texas, Humble, Texas, Mesquite, Texas, and San Antonio, Texas. We're also coming from Taylorsville, Utah, Alexandria, Virginia, Chesapeake, Virginia, Manassas, Virginia, Norfolk, Virginia, and Virginia Beach, Virginia. Amboy, Washington, Graham, Washington, Tacoma, Washington, Charleston, West Virginia, Eclair, Wisconsin. We're also coming from Hamilton, Canada, Kitchener, Canada, Manitoba, Canada, Mississauga, if I'm saying that right, Canada, Mississauga, Ontario, Canada, Oshawa, Canada, Scarborough, Canada, and Toronto, Canada. Internationally, we're coming from Johannesburg, South Africa, Nairobi, Kenya. We're coming from the Bahamas. We're coming from Deluxe, Republic of Ireland, County Meath, Ireland, Portsmouth, Jamaica. We're also coming from Greater London, Queensland, Australia, Renault Koleos, Australia, Ternopil, Ethiopia, and Ukraine.
So we coming out. We all over. Praise God. Thank you, Brother Donnell. All right, so the title of today's lesson is "The Instruction of the Lord Shall Not Be Interrupted." Because the Lord got instructions out here, and he got instructors. And a lot of times, well, most of the time, those instructions are ignored. And you got disruptive people that interrupt those instructions. So we're going to read some examples today of showing you why and how the Lord operate when he lay instruction down and how he want things done, carried out his way, not to overdo nothing or to underdo nothing. So I chose to start it off in Numbers, the 22nd chapter. And we're going to read, a little bit about Moses and, because Moses was like a commanding general. A lot of people don't know that. And Moses was taking care of the Lord's business. And the Lord was delivering nations into their hands time after time. But we're a stiff-necked nation of people. And we get real pompous and arrogant and jealous at the drop of a hat when we feel like we ain't included in something, instead of just following instruction. So we're going to do some reading. I know y'all are like, we reading the whole chapter. We got time. We're going to get through it. The lesson looks short, though. So, it's going to even out. So we're going to read a little bit. And we're going to get through it. Let's start off in Numbers, the 22nd chapter. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1. When you get it, Brother Real, go ahead.
"And the children of Israel set forward and pitched in the plains of Moab on this side Jordan by Jericho. Mm-hmm. And Balak the son of Zippor saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites."
Yeah, they defeated them. Go ahead.
"And Moab was sore afraid of the people because they were many."
Yep.
"And Moab was distressed because of the children of Israel."
Yeah,
because
like I said, the Lord had Israel getting down. He have 1,000 flee at 7 of us or something like that. That's how the Lord was getting down for us. Go ahead.
"And Moab said unto the elders of Midian, Now shall this company lick up all that are round about us, as the ox licketh up the grass of the field."
Yep.
"And Balak the son of Zippor was king of the Moabites at that time."
So we had a Moabite king at this time who was just adamant on, getting his revenge on Israel. Go ahead.
"He sent messengers therefore unto Balaam the son of Beor to Pethor, which is by the river of the land of the children of his people, to call him, saying, Behold, there is a people come out from Egypt. Behold, they cover the face of the earth, and they abide over against me."
Because then the Lord tell Abraham he was going to make his seed like the sand of the sea, right? Yep. Go ahead.
"Come now, therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people, for they are too mighty for me."
So now he's trying to curse some that the Lord bless. Go ahead.
"Peradventure I shall prevail, that we may smite them, and that I may drive them out of the land. For I would that he whom thou blessest is blessed, and he whom thou cursest is cursed."
Go ahead.
"And the elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the rewards of divination in their hand. And they came unto Balaam and spake unto him the words of Balak."
So Balak sent some messages to Balaam trying to convince him to, come on with me and let me curse. Let's curse the people of Israel. Come on, go ahead.
"And he said unto them, Lodge here this night, and I will bring you word again, as the Lord shall speak unto me. And the princes of Moab abode with Balaam. And God came unto Balaam and said, What man are these with thee? And Balaam said unto God, Balak the son of Zippor, king of Moab, have sent unto me, saying, Behold, there is a people come out of Egypt, which covereth the face of the earth. Come now, curse me them. Peradventure I shall be able to overcome them and drive them out."
So now you're trying to get the Lord to curse his people who he set up. How foolish can you be? I ain't calling no fool, but how stupid a decision are you trying to make? Go ahead.
"And God said unto Balaam, Thou shalt not go with them."
That's a given. Go ahead.
"Thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed."
Go ahead.
"And Balaam rose up in the morning and said unto the princes of Balak, Get you into your land, for the Lord refuseth to give me leave to go with you."
So he instructed right. He got the instruction. He relayed the message right. But let's see what happened. Go ahead.
"And the princes of Moab rose up, and they went unto Balak and said, Balaam refuseth to come with us."
Which was he should have did, because he got the true and living God. He ain't got to worry about no king of Moab or the Amorite. He ain't got to worry about nobody, because at that time the Lord had the Israel on top.
That's right.
We ain't had no problem. Go ahead.
"And Balak sent yet again princes more and more honorable than they."
So they going to send some more stout fellows up there with, more, probably have more armor on, probably taller, more buff, whatever the case may be. You know how You know, Israel, we are visual people, so if we see somebody, you know, if they come deeper, you know, which mean more, you know, we get shook up. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
And they came to Balaam and said to him, thus saith Balak the son of Zippor, let nothing, I pray thee, hinder thee from coming unto me.
Yeah.
For I will promote thee unto very great honor, and I will do whatsoever thou sayest unto me.
So now he's trying to give out titles. Now he's trying to give out ranking. Go ahead.
Come therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people.
Yeah, because you know, Israel, we like to accept gifts and bribes. You know what I'm saying? And the other nations know that. So they you know, they taking advantage of only what they can see. We can't blame them. Go ahead.
And Balaam answered and said unto the servants of Balak, if Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I cannot go beyond the word of the Lord my God to do less or more.
See what I'm saying? But see, he had the right response there. He said, nah, man, look, you can give me all your house, all your gold, your possession, but I can't do more than what the Lord told me to do. And I for sure can't do less. Go ahead.
Now, therefore, I pray you, tarry ye also here this night, that I may know what the Lord will say unto me more.
So instead of him just getting up out of there, he said, okay, man, look, wait with me again for the night. I'm going to go holler at my God, and he going to give me instruction. Go ahead.
And God came unto Balaam at night and said unto him, if the man come to call thee, rise up and go with them. But yet the word which I shall say unto thee, that shalt thou
now,
do.
Now you see what the Lord told him? The Lord said, okay. You should have got up out of there. He said, but go ahead on, go on with him. It's like you tell your child or something like that. Now, I told you can't go outside. And the child keep on asking, well, go ahead on. Go ahead.
And Balaam rose up in the morning and saddled his ass and went with the princes of Moab. And God's anger was kindled because he went.
Now, did the Lord told him to go, though, right? But you see how he got upset when he went? Go ahead.
And the angel of the Lord stood in the way for an adversary against him.
Yeah.
Now he was riding upon his ass.
His donkey, go ahead.
And his two servants were with him.
Yep.
And the ass saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way.
Yeah.
And his sword drawn in his hand.
Uh-huh.
And the ass turned aside out of the way and went into the field. And Balaam smote the ass to turn her into the way.
Now the donkey know what's going on more than the man. Because the donkey can see what's going on. He got tunnel vision. He see one of these warriors of the Lord coming to lay you down. Period. Go ahead.
But the angel of the Lord stood in the path of the vineyard, a wall being on this side and a wall on that side.
So the angel cornered him off. You ain't going to come here. I got to holler at you. Go ahead.
And when the ass saw that the angel of the Lord, she thrust herself unto the wall.
I don't blame him. Go ahead.
And crushed Balaam's foot against the wall.
Uh-huh.
And he smote her again.
And he hit again. He beating this animal. Because this animal, it's got to be something wrong if the animal is distraught and just, you know, go ahead.
And the angel of the Lord went further and stood in a narrow place where was no way to turn either to the right hand or to the left.
Uh-huh.
And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she fell down under Balaam.
Uh-huh.
And Balaam's anger was kindled, and he smote the ass with the staff.
And it's the third time he didn't struck this animal. And it got to be a reason that the animal ain't going to just do that on for nothing. The animal been with him all the animal life. He gonna let him know. Go ahead.
And the Lord opened the mouth of the ass.
Oh, wait a minute now. So now the Lord then made a animal open up his mouth and deliver a message to you. Now, I don't know if it was Hebrew or whatever language. We ain't finna get into that. But this donkey just opened his mouth to talk to you. Go ahead.
And she said unto Balaam, what have I done unto thee that thou hast smitten me these three times?
Yeah.
And Balaam said unto the ass, because thou hast mocked me, I would there were a sword in mine hand, for now would I kill thee.
Oh, wow. So now you going to kill him for mocking you. But what should the Lord do to you when he told you already what to do with you and you decided to do otherwise, to do it anyway? Go ahead.
And the ass said unto Balaam, am not I thine ass, upon which thou hast ridden ever since I was thine unto this day? Was I ever wont to do so unto thee? And he said, nay.
So he answered him, no. So he contradicted himself. You sit up here beating on me, ain't I yours? Didn't I do everything? You tied 1,000 pounds to me. I'll do it for you. I'll walk for you. I didn't do whatever you wanted me to do. What you hit me for? What you beating on me for? Because you feeling guilty about something. Go ahead.
Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam.
Yeah.
And he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way.
That's what it was. It was an angel of the Lord. That's why that donkey was doing what he did. Because Because the donkey had sense enough to, look, man, hey, you ain't finna get me slayed up in here. Go ahead.
And his sword drawn in his hand.
Uh-huh.
And he bowed down his head and fell flat on his face.
Go ahead.
And the angel of the Lord said unto him, wherefore hast thou smitten thine ass these three times?
Yeah.
Behold, I went out to withstand thee.
Yeah.
Because thy way is perverse before me. Because,
see, the angel, he gonna carry out the instruction reluctantly, resiliently, regardless. That's what they was created for. So he going to take care of the business, hands down. Go ahead.
And the ass saw me and turned from me these three times. Unless she had turned from me, surely now also I had slain thee and saved her alive.
So so much for animal cruelty. The Lord was finna save an animal and kill one of his messengers. So come on now. Go ahead.
And Balaam said unto the angel of the Lord, I have sinned, for I knew not that thou stoodest in the way against me. Now, therefore, if it displease thee, I will get me back again.
So now he ready to follow instruction. Go ahead.
And the angel of the Lord said unto Balaam, go with the men, but only the word that I shall speak unto thee, that thou shalt speak.
So he said, go ahead on with him, but let me coach this thing. Right? Because we try, a lot of times in life, we try to coach things and we go overboard, or we come up short. Let the Lord coach you. Go ahead.
So Balaam went with the princes of Balak.
Uh-huh.
And when Balak heard that Balaam was come, he went out to meet him into a city of Moab, which is in the border of Arnon, which is in the utmost coast.
Yeah.
And Balak said unto Balaam, did I not earnestly send unto thee to call thee? Wherefore camest thou not unto me? Am I not able indeed to promote thee to honor?
Right. So he's saying, look, man, you did all this, man. I'm the one that can put you on, man. I could put you on top. So you're going to deal with, okay, but at the same time, you asking me to go deal with my God for answers for you. You see how that's working? It's a common sense error that's being made. Just follow instruction. But see, Balak is trying to interrupt this thing. Go ahead.
And Balaam said unto Balak, lo, I am come unto thee. Have I now any power at all to say anything? The word that God putteth in my mouth, that shall I speak. And Balaam went with Balak, and they came unto Gergev, who's off. And Balak offered oxen and sheep, and sent to Balaam and to the princes that were with him. And it came to pass on the morrow that Balak took Balaam and brought him up unto the high places of Baal, that thence he might see the utmost part of the people.
Go over to the 23rd chapter and read it. Start at 1.
And Balaam said unto Balak, build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 oxen and 7 rams.
Yep.
And Balak did as Balaam had spoken.
Yep.
And Balak and Balaam offered on every altar a bullock and a ram.
So you see how Balak did that. He followed instruction when it was convenient for him, because he's trying to get an ass out of Balaam. Go ahead.
And Balaam said unto Balak,
excuse me,
stand by thy burnt offering, and I will go. Peradventure the Lord will come to meet me, and whatsoever he showeth me, I will tell thee.
So no matter what, the Lord going to be against you, my dude. So we can do all this, what you want me to do. You want me to go back and intercede for you back and forth? It's going to be, you're going to get the same result. Go ahead.
And he went to an high place,
and
God met Balaam, and he said unto him, I have prepared 7 altars, and I have offered upon every altar a bullock and a ram.
Yeah.
And the Lord put a word in Balaam's mouth.
You put it in his mouth. The Lord put it in his mouth, right? Balaam ain't go off his own, man. Go ahead.
And said, return unto Balak, and thus thou shalt speak.
Yeah.
And he returned unto him. And lo, he stood by his burnt sacrifice, he and all the princes of Moab. And he took up his parable and said, Balak the king of Moab have brought me from Aram, out of the mountains of the east, saying, come, curse me, Jacob, and come, defy Israel.
Big mistake. You gonna tell me you're going to defy the Lord's chosen? The Lord's anointed, the one who the Lord adopted to put over every nation on the earth. You want me to curse him? You crazy. Go ahead.
How shall I curse whom God have not cursed?
Yeah.
Or how shall I defy whom the Lord have not defied?
Go ahead.
For from the top of the rocks I see him.
Yeah.
And from the hills I behold him.
Yeah.
Lo, the people shall dwell alone and shall not be reckoned among the nations.
Go ahead.
Who can count the dust of Jacob and the number of the fourth part of Israel?
Yo, that's a question. Go ahead.
Let me die the death of the righteous, and let my last end be like his.
So he stood up. Now he's standing up. Now he doing what he's supposed to do. That's a bold statement. He said, let me die to death than to go against my God. Go ahead.
And Balak said unto Balaam, what hast thou done unto me? I took thee to curse mine enemy. And behold, thou hast blessed them altogether.
So he said, man, you going against the grain. He said, now hold on. Now I brought you here to get me get down on these guys. But you sitting up here talking about some other, you going to ride or die for your God. Go ahead.
And he answered and said, must I not take heed to speak that which the Lord hath put in my mouth?
Go ahead.
And Balak said unto him, come, I pray thee, with me unto another place.
He say, now come on. He like, it's going to change something. Come on over here now. Come on, get away from here. Come on over here. And let's do the same procedure again. Because he hoping for another answer. Because that's what we do. When we don't get the answer we want, we hope for something else. Go ahead.
From whence thou mayest see them. Thou shalt see but the utmost part of them, and shalt not see them all, and curse me them from thence. And he brought him into the field of Zophim, to the top of Pisgah, and built 7 altars, and offered a bullock and a ram on every altar.
Go ahead.
And he said unto Balak, stand here by thy burnt offering, while I meet the Lord yonder.
Right.
And the Lord met Balaam and put a word in his mouth and said, go again unto Balaam.
So the Lord gonna play ping pong with him. He say, you want to play these type of games? All right, come on over here. Go tell him that. Go ahead.
And say thus, and when he came to him, behold, he stood by his burnt offering, and the princes of Moab with him. And Balak said unto him, what hath the Lord spoken?
Did he say anything? Is he going to go against Israel? Let's see. Go ahead.
And he took up his parable and said, rise up, Balak, and hear. Hearken unto me, thou son of Zippor.
Yeah.
God is not a man that he should lie.
No, he not. Go.
Neither the son of man that he should repent.
Right.
Hath he said, and shall he not do it?
Yeah, he going to do it. Go ahead.
Or hath he spoken, and shall he not make it good?
Go ahead.
Behold, I have received commandment to bless, and he hath blessed, and I cannot reverse.
He said, man, so I got the commandment to bless these people. I can't overturn no instruction that the Lord, so you want me to interrupt the Lord's program? And you got people out here that's doing it every Sunday with their wins and their doctrines. With the food they like to eat, and they say it's all right. You interrupting the Lord's program. I don't care whether you like it or not. Go ahead.
He hath not beheld iniquity in Jacob. Neither hath he seen perverseness in Israel. The Lord his God is with him. And the shout of a king is among
That's
them.
That's right. Go ahead.
God brought them out of Egypt. He hath, as it were, the strength of a unicorn.
Of a rhinoceros. That's pretty strong. Go ahead.
Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob. Neither is there any divination against Israel.
Go ahead.
According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what have God wrought?
Go ahead.
Behold, the people shall rise up as a great lion and lift up himself as a young lion. He shall not lie down until he eat of the prey and drink the blood of the slain.
Go ahead.
And Balak said unto Balaam, neither curse them at all, nor bless them at all.
Right.
But Balaam answered and said unto Balak, told not I thee, saying, all that the Lord speaketh, that I must do?
So now he going to try to even out the scale. He say, well, okay, well, they don't bless them, don't curse them either. You see what he's trying to get over. But you can't get over on the Lord. I don't care how intelligent or what books you've read. Go ahead.
And Balak said unto Balaam, come, I pray thee, I will bring thee unto another place.
Yeah.
Peradventure it will please God that thou mayest curse me them from thence.
So you see what's going on here. This man is reprobate in thinking. He thinking he can get over it. And the man just told him, and it's going to happen to you in life. People going to come at you steady trying to give you something. Steady trying to feed you swine. Steady trying to slip something unclean to you. Steady want you to misbehave with them. And you're going to have to keep with the same responses, whether it get them on their nerves or whether they forbear to hear it. It's all on you. Go ahead.
And Balak brought Balaam unto the top of Peor that looketh toward Jeshimon.
Which don't mean nothing. You just brought him somewhere else to get sent off again. Go ahead.
And Balaam said unto Balak, build me here 7 altars and prepare me here 7 bullocks and 7 rams.
He said, I'm going to do it again. Come on.
And Balak did as Balaam had said and offered a bullock and a ram on every altar.
Okay, so this ain't on your program, but we're going to go right to the next chapter and we're going to read a few verses here. Don't worry about it. Go to chapter 24 and pick it up at verse 10 just to see the outcome of what he told him again. Go ahead. Chapter 24, verse 10. Go ahead, Brother Rail.
And Balak's anger was kindled against Balak.
So now you mad because you ain't getting what you want. Go ahead.
And he smote his hands together.
Mm-hmm.
And Balak said unto Balaam, I called thee to curse mine enemy. And behold, thou hast altogether blessed them these three times.
So I called you to go against the Lord. I'm interrupting the Lord, and I want you to be disruptive as well. And I don't want you to follow instruction. I want you to listen to me. Go ahead.
Therefore now, flee thou to thy place.
Uh-huh.
I thought to promote thee unto great honor.
Mm-hmm.
But lo, the Lord have kept thee back from honor.
So I want to put you on. Now he trying to turn his God. He trying to turn him against his God. And ain't that what Satan do?
Yes, sir.
Satan wants you to go against the program.
That's right.
Because Satan ain't want to be with the program. He wanted to be over the program. Go ahead.
And Balaam said unto Balak,
mm-hmm.
Spake I not also to thy messengers,
yeah.
which thou sendest unto me,
uh-huh.
saying, if Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I cannot go beyond the commandment of the Lord
uh-huh.
to do either good or bad uh-huh. in my own mind.
That's right. Go ahead.
But what the Lord saith, that will I speak.
We understood. So I can't go. Look, man, I know they didn't enslave your people and beat you down, but I can't go against these guys because this one's the Lord set up. This ain't for me to do. This not my call. I got to go off what the Lord said. The Lord say bless them, they bless. Let's go to Numbers, the 16th chapter. And we're going to go ahead and get some instruction how the Lord want things to be done. And the Lord, so basically, point blank, this is a little bit after some guy got killed. Moses had him killed for picking up sticks on the Sabbath. It's a little bit after that. And we're just going to read how puffed up some of these, how Israel got against it. We're going to read it out, though. I ain't going to spoil it because some people probably never read it. You can read. I suggest you read this whole book. It's a good book. The whole thing is, but we're going to start at chapter 16 of verse 1 of Numbers. Go ahead, Brother Real.
Now Kor, the son of Izhar,
uh-huh.
the son of Kohath,
mm-hmm.
the son of Levi,
mm-hmm.
and Dathan, and Abiram, the sons of Eliab,
uh-huh.
and On, the son of Peleth,
mm-hmm.
sons of Reuben, took men.
Yeah.
And they rose up before Moses with certain of the children of Israel,
uh-huh.
250 princes of the assembly,
mm.
famous in the congregation,
uh-huh.
men of renown.
So these brothers is you know, everybody know these brothers. These brothers are probably knowledgeable and you know, scriptures and morality, and everybody look up to them, right? Princes, right? Real, sound real good, don't it? And but they rose up against Moses, an instructor of the Lord. Go ahead.
And they gathered themselves together against Moses and against Aaron.
His brother, go ahead.
And said unto them, ye take too much upon you, seeing all the congregation are holy.
Right.
Every one of them.
Go ahead.
The Lord is among them.
Right.
Wherefore then lift ye up yourselves above the congregation of the Lord.
Huh?
And when Moses heard it, he fell upon his face.
So Moses know what's going on. Moses say, now y'all tripping. So Moses, because Moses plenty of times had to intercede for Israel because
right.
the Lord was ready to wipe them out.
Right.
I'm talking about kill them all. He even told Moses, I'm going to start over with you. I can do it. Don't worry. Go ahead.
And he spake unto Kor and unto all his company, saying, even tomorrow the Lord will show who are his
right.
and who is holy.
Right.
And will cause him to come near unto him.
Mm-hmm.
Even him who he have chosen will he cause to come near unto him.
So he gonna let you know who his instructors are and who is holy. He gonna let y'all know. All y'all princes with these titles and these with your chest puffed out and mad at me because the Lord put me up in a position to do something. He gonna show you now. Because I done fell on my face for you. I feel for you. I feel sorry for you. Go ahead.
This do. Take you censers, Korah, and all his company, and put fire therein, and put incense in them before the Lord tomorrow.
Right.
And it shall be, if the man whom the Lord doth choose, he shall be holy.
Right.
Ye take too much upon you, ye sons of Levi.
You see where this is going? Go ahead.
And Moses said unto Korah, hear, I pray you, ye sons of Levi.
Yeah.
Seemeth it but a small thing unto you? that the Lord God of Israel have separated you from the congregation of Israel to bring you near to himself, to do the service of the tabernacle of the Lord, and to stand before the congregation to minister unto them.
Go ahead.
And he have brought thee near to him, and all thy brethren, the sons of Levi, with thee, and seek ye the priesthood also.
So he's saying, y'all got everything else. He said, just let the Lord put this up. Let the Lord distribute how he want to give out these titles and these jobs and this. And whatever, y'all just hold fast. But if y'all want it, we gonna see tomorrow. Tough guys. What are we going to now?
Verse 19.
Skip down to verse 19. Go ahead.
And Korah gathered all the congregation against them unto the door of the tabernacle of the congregation.
Yeah.
And the glory of the Lord appeared unto all the congregation.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord spake unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying.
Here go instruction. Go ahead.
Separate yourselves from among this congregation,
yep.
that I may consume them in a moment.
Here we go. Go ahead.
And they fell upon their faces and said, O God, the God of the spirits of all flesh,
yep.
shall one man sin, and wilt thou be wroth with all the congregation?
Evidently, it could have been, because what he was finna do?
Get them all.
Over one man, right?
That's right.
Go ahead.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying,
yeah.
Speak unto the congregation, saying, get you up from about the tabernacle of Korah, Dathan, and Abiram.
Get up away from them guys. Come on.
And Moses rose up and went unto Dathan and Abiram, and the elders of Israel followed him.
Yeah.
And he spake unto the congregation, saying, depart, I pray you, from the tents of these wicked men,
yep.
and touch nothing of theirs, lest ye be consumed in all their sins.
Uh-oh, so that means that somebody doing wicked, you need to go and get up away from them.
That's right.
You might be married to somebody wicked. Hmm. You can't put them away, but you might not want to, you know, if they want to take you to something you ain't got no business, you can't go to no strip club with them because they might be into that. Oh, it's out here.
Yeah.
They might want you to, you know, right. stake out and why they robbing the bank. Right. You can't do that. Right. You know, but you go in there and fix them something to eat and rub their feet.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
So they got up from the tabernacle of Korah,
yeah.
Dathan and Abiram,
yeah.
on every side. And Dathan and Abiram came out and stood in the door of their tents and their wives
yeah.
and their sons and their little children.
Yeah.
And Moses said, hereby ye shall know that the Lord have sent me to do all these works.
Yeah.
For I have not done them of mine own mind.
He didn't do them of what? His own mind. He going off simple instructions that the Lord set up for him. Go ahead.
If these men die the common death of all men, or if they be visited after the visitation of all men, then the Lord hath not sent me.
Go ahead.
But if the Lord make a new thing,
yeah.
and the earth open her mouth, and swallow them up with all that appertain unto them,
right.
and they go down quick into the pit, then ye shall understand that these men have provoked the Lord.
So now that Moses then gave them the itinerary of what should happen, what shouldn't happen. Go ahead.
And it came to pass, as he had made an end of speaking all these words, that the ground clave asunder that was under them, and the earth opened her mouth
yep.
and swallowed them up,
yep.
and their houses, and all the men that appertain unto Korah, and all their goods.
For being what? Disruptive. Oh, because y'all, you know what? Y'all doing too much. Oh, okay, was y'all in here? You teaching, you burning, you doing sacrifices. Oh, you doing this, you doing that. You speaking for him, he speaking for you. Who y'all think y'all is? Now you in a pickle.
Right.
Go ahead.
They and all that appertain to them went down alive into the pit.
Alive. Go ahead.
And the earth closed upon them, and they perished from among the congregation.
I couldn't imagine. I saw a movie, Kill Bill, where she was in a box in the dirt, and I got claustrophobic. I was losing my breath watching that part. So I can imagine you going down in pure earth and dirt. Mm. You ain't got nothing to even suffocate slowly in. Mm. That's tough. Go ahead.
And all Israel that were round about them fled at the cry of them.
Mm-hmm.
For they said, lest the earth swallow us
I
up
know
also.
That, I know that's right. Go ahead.
And there came out a fire from the Lord
mm-hmm.
and consumed the 250 men that offered incense.
Need I say more? These 250 princes, right? These ain't no regular Joe Schmoes here. We done with that, Brother Real?
Yes, sir.
Let's go to Exodus 4. Y'all thought this lesson was real short, didn't y'all?
Gotcha.
But no, we going here because the Lord's instruction is his instruction, period. And y'all, you see what type of man of the Lord Moses was. Everybody think he was soft and, you know, so humble that, you know, it ain't the case. But the Lord ain't going to choose nobody weak, because Moses even tried to get out of following instructions, and somehow he got a speech impediment or something like that. The Lord said, no, don't worry about that. Your brother, he going to ride with you. So ain't no getting from up out of this. But the Lord, you know, had some love for Moses. He buried Moses on his own, didn't he?
That's right.
But it's like I say, instruction is instruction. And when the Lord had you to do something, you just need to do it. And know sometimes you might not want to do it, but you got to do it. So where we at? Exodus 4, and pick it up at verse 19. When you get it, go ahead.
And the Lord said unto Moses in Midian, mm-hmm. Go, return into Egypt. For all the men are dead which sought thy life. And Moses took his wife and his sons and set them upon an ass. And he returned to the land of Egypt. And Moses took the rod of God in his hand. And the Lord said unto Moses, when thou goest to return into Egypt, see that thou do all those wonders before Pharaoh, which I have put in thine hand. But I will harden his heart that he shall not let the people go.
Right.
And thou shalt say unto Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord, Israel is my son, even my firstborn. And I say unto thee, let my son go, that he may serve me. And if thou refuse to let him go, behold, I will slay thy son, even thy firstborn.
So now the Lord has sent one of his top general to go carry out a mission. And Moses ain't back down off nothing, you know. Some things have probably slipped his mind or something like that. But he, look at all the stuff he had on his plate. You know, and these brothers and instructors, they got a lot going on, you know. Go ahead.
And it came to pass by the way in the end that the Lord met him and sought to kill him.
Now, wait a minute. Did the actual Lord come meet him? No. He sent one of the messengers to come kill him. After he just told him to go take care of the business, which he was finna do regardless. But he forgot to do something. Let's see. Go ahead.
Then Zipporah took a sharp stone and cut off the foreskin of her son and cast it at his feet.
Yeah.
And said, surely a bloody husband art thou to me.
Now, this is a stranger. His wife, who had enough knowledge and sense to take care of that business, she just saved her husband's life because the Lord was finna end it. Mm. One of his top men. That should show you that the Lord is serious about instructions. Go ahead.
So he let him go.
Uh-huh.
Then she said, a bloody husband thou art because of the circumcision.
You know, she was going to throw it in his face. You know, but hey, that's what it is. We done with that, brother?
Yes, sir.
Let's go to Matthew, the 12th chapter. Matthew 12, and we're going to pick it up at verse 30. Let me make sure I'm on point. And yeah, and I'm going here because, you know, if you're giving somebody instruction, not off your own mind, you know, because we got brothers who got some knowledge, but they going off instruction in their own mind, and they doing it to gain evil reputation. Not saying on purpose, but that's what they gain. Because if I see the book say don't multiply horses and wives, and you around here got four of them living all in one or two bedroom apartment, you doing wicked. You being wicked. Ain't no other action for that. You not following instructions. So if you get somebody some knowledge and they go, nah, brother, well, you, that's your interpretation and all. You got to move around. You got to let it go. Matthew 12 and verse 30. Go ahead, brother.
He that is not with me is against me. Mm-hmm. And he that gathereth not with me scattereth abroad. Wherefore I say unto you, all manner of sin and blasphemy shall be forgiven unto men.
Mm-hmm.
But the blasphemy against the Holy Ghost shall not be forgiven unto men.
Why? Why is he saying this? Finish that.
And whosoever speaketh a word against the Son of Man, it shall be forgiven him.
Uh-huh.
But whosoever speaketh against the Holy Ghost, it shall not be forgiven him,
right,
neither in this world, neither in the world to come.
So now we got a problem on the table. Because It's saying the Lord, the Lord saying you can speak against the Son of Man. I'm gonna give you a pass. But this Holy Ghost here, he gonna take care of the business. Now or later, you choose. How we know that? Let's go back to Exodus. Y'all can go back. We got time. We got plenty of time still. Exodus chapter 23. And pick it up at verse 20, Brother Rail. When you get it, go ahead.
Behold, I send an angel before thee to keep thee in the way.
To keep you in the way, to keep you in line. Go ahead.
And to bring thee into the place which I have prepared.
Yeah.
Beware of him.
But he say, be what?
Beware of him.
And don't say, don't worry about him. It say, beware this entity, because, go ahead.
And obey his voice.
Yeah.
Provoke him not.
Yep.
For he will not pardon your transgressions.
Uh-huh.
For my name is in him.
It reminded me of a movie called Goodfellas. And Joe Pesci was just the wild cowboy. And Paulie was a calm, he was still a gangster and a killer, but Joe Pesci, no matter what, he gonna execute the plan. he gonna knock you down. If your mama get out of line, he gonna knock her down. You understand? That's what this angel here to do. He not here to play games with you. And I'm not being tough or hard on you or, you know, want to be saying that, you know, we gangsters. I'm just saying that the Lord does not play with his instruction. And the angel is an instructor too, because that's who we got it from. That's why the prophets put this in here, for us to eat it up like a roll and for us to live like this. We finished, Brother Rail?
Yes, sir.
Where we at? Let's go to Genesis. We still on instruction. Y'all still with me?
Yeah.
I ain't trying to put nobody to sleep. I'm sorry. We're going to go to Genesis, the 19th chapter. Instruction is instructing. I just want y'all, when y'all leave here today, y'all remember, instruction, don't interrupt the Lord's. I don't care what you're doing at work. You know, keep your job. I ain't saying get fired, but follow instructions of the Lord that the Lord set up and his instructors, and respect that authority. We all have to. I know we think we got a better ideas, but let the Lord work it out. Genesis 19, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. When you get it, brother, go ahead.
And there came two angels to Sodom at even.
Uh-huh.
And Lot sat in the gate of Sodom.
Mm.
And Lot, seeing them, rose up to meet them.
Mm.
And he bowed himself with his face toward the ground.
So now these angels came there to take care of the business. They weren't coming there on a retreat and to relax. Because remember, remember we just read it. That's all an angel is the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Or a ministering spirit.
Right.
It's not God. They're just messengers of God. And a voice for God. That's it. Go ahead.
And he said, behold now, my lords, turn in, I pray you, into your servant's house.
Uh-huh.
And tarry all night and wash your feet.
Yeah.
And you shall rise up early and go on your way.
Yep.
And they said, nay, but we will abide in the street all night.
Right.
And he pressed upon them greatly.
Mm.
And they turned in unto him and entered into his house.
Because, see, they just wanted to parlay in the street because they know what they came to do. They came to take a bath, a bloody one. That's all they came to do. And get them people up out of there. And we're going to read it, though. I ain't going to spoil it for you. Go ahead.
And he made them a feast and did bake unleavened bread, and they did eat.
Uh-huh.
But before they lay down, the men of the city, even the men of Sodom, compassed the house round. Both old and young, all the people from every quarter.
So why was they doing that? Why was these men all up at this house like this? It ain't say nothing about no women. Mm. It said what? It say men of Sodom compassed the house round about old and young. Mm. Go ahead.
And they called unto Lot
mm.
and said unto him, where are the men which came in to thee this night?
Now these some nosy neighbors. But it's something else a little bit more strange and peculiar about these neighbors. Go ahead.
Bring them out unto us
mm.
that we may know them.
Now what you mean?
Yeah.
You could, a man and woman can only know each other in a biblical sense.
That's right.
Right? That's the only way to reproduce. That's the only way to be fruitful and multiply. That's the only way your hormones are supposed to react towards one another is a man and a woman. Period. I'm just gonna go ahead and say it. Man with man is an abomination, so is woman with woman. Go ahead and read.
And Lot went out at the door unto them and shut the door after him and said, I pray you, brethren, do not so wicked.
He said, don't do this wicked. This is evil. This thing y'all talking about. Because he know what they came to do. Go ahead.
We'll skip.
Where we at? Skip down to verse 12. I'm sorry, Brother Rick.
And the man said unto Lot, hast thou here any besides son-in-law and thy sons and thy daughters, and whatsoever thou hast in the city, bring them out of this place.
So the angels already knew, which came as men. They already knew what these wicked men wanted to do. They wanted to lay with them and rape them and abuse them. But you couldn't do that to these guys. These were some other type of guys. Go ahead.
For we will destroy this place.
They gonna what? They're going to destroy it. They're going to tear it up. They follow instructions. Go ahead.
Because the cry of them is waxing great before the face of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord has sent us to destroy it.
Uh-huh. Skip down to verse 17.
And it came to pass, when they had brought them forth abroad, that he said, escape for thy life.
Mm-hmm.
Look not behind
thee. There it is. He said, escape for your life, because they're finna tear it up. Don't look behind you. Just get up out of here. Go, go, go. Go ahead.
Neither stay thou in all the plain.
Yeah.
Escape to the mountain.
Yeah.
Lest thou be consumed.
Yep.
And Lot said unto them, oh, not so, my lord.
Go ahead.
Behold, now thy servant hath found grace in thy sight, and thou hast magnified thy mercy, which thou hast shown unto me in saving my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I cannot escape to the mountain, lest some evil take me and I die.
That's another. We ain't going to get into that. Skip down to verse 22.
Haste thee, escape thither. For I cannot do anything till thou be come thither.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, the name of the city was called Zoar.
Uh-huh.
The sun was risen upon the earth when Lot entered into Zoar.
Uh-huh.
Then the Lord rained upon Sodom and upon Gomorrah, brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven.
Because they wanted to do what we're doing now. And we're so the end thing right now. We got men wanting to be women. Men that are converting themselves over mentally and semi-biologically to women. And we got women that's doing the same thing.
Wow.
We got men that want to have wombs. And what the Lord do here? He burn it up with brimstone. And that ain't no charcoal. Wow. We talking about substance that they still got residue of it over there.
Mm.
Go ahead.
And he overthrew those cities and all the plain and all the inhabitants of the city and that which grew upon the ground.
Yeah.
But his wife looked back behind him.
Yeah, she did. And what else?
And she became a pillar of salt.
I said, get up out of here and don't look back. It could have been anybody. I ain't attacking no woman. I'm just saying it could have been anybody. So if we just follow instructions, simple and plain, we ain't gonna have these problems. We let the Lord coach the thing and don't take it upon yourself to add nothing or take nothing. Let's go back to Exodus. Y'all be all right. Exodus 30. Let's see where I'm at on my program. Okay. Like I'm saying, don't do overly good or overly evil. Because once you do overly good, first of all, you pumping yourself up to be something that you ain't got to do. And that's how you fall off, because you overwhelm yourself. And you can hit rock bottom just as quick as you got the knowledge. You can lose it and abuse it. Exodus 30. Read verse 1.
And thou shalt make an altar to burn incense upon.
Uh-huh.
Of shittim wood shalt thou make it.
So now if you all want to read how critique and how precise the Lord is with making this stuff, y'all can read it. I ain't got a problem with that. But we're going to get straight to the meat of what we're trying to get to today. Skip down to verse 6. But this was a simple instruction. He laid it out for him and told him how to do it. Read hit verse 6, Brother Real.
And thou shalt put it before the veil that is by the ark of the testimony.
Yeah.
Before the mercy seat that is over the testimony, where I will meet with thee.
Yeah.
And Aaron shall burn thereon sweet incense every morning. When he dresseth the lamps, he shall burn incense upon it.
He said Aaron, right?
That's right.
Go ahead.
And when Aaron lighteth the lamps at even, he shall burn incense upon it.
He said Aaron, right?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
A perpetual incense before the Lord throughout your generations.
Mm-hmm. Now, we know Aaron ain't going to last for all the generations, but right now, this is just precisely what the Lord's saying to do. Go ahead.
Ye shall offer no strange incense thereon.
So what's strange? Anything that the Lord said not to do is strange.
Right.
A man laying with a man is strange. Go ahead.
Nor burnt sacrifice, nor meat offering, neither shall ye pour drink offering thereon. And Aaron shall make an atonement upon the horns of it once in a year with the blood of the sin offering of atonement. Once in a year shall he make atonement upon it throughout your generation. It is most holy unto the Lord.
Let's go to Leviticus, the 10th chapter. We're going to show y'all something. That was understood, right? Anybody got any objections? We all caught that with how the Lord said do it, who he said he wanted to do it. Of course, he was going to have to send somebody else to do it after the passing of Aaron, but the Lord worked that out, right? Yeah. Or he set up instructors to work it out. Leviticus chapter 10, and pick it up at verse 1. When you get it, Brother Real, go ahead.
And Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron.
The sons of the guy who he said was in charge of doing this thing. His sons. Go ahead.
Took either of them his censer and put fire therein and put incense thereon and offered strange fire before the Lord.
Come on now. Come on. These the sons of one of the bosses. Go ahead.
Which he commanded them not.
Go ahead.
And there went out fire from the Lord and devoured them. And they died before the Lord.
Instantaneously. Now, I'm not boasting about their death. I'm just saying instant fire. Just came out there and ate them people up. The Lord loved working with fire when he destroyed. He did it with water. He said he ain't going to do water no more, so he going to use that fire. Go ahead.
Then Moses said unto Aaron, this is it that the Lord spake, saying, I will be sanctified in them that come nigh me, and before all the people I will be glorified.
Yeah.
And Aaron held his peace.
Mm-hmm.
And Moses called Mishael and Elzaphan, the sons of Uziel, the uncle of Aaron, and said unto them, come near, carry your brethren from before the sanctuary out of the camp.
Right.
So they went near and carried them in their coats out of the camp, and as Moses had said.
Mm-hmm.
And Moses said unto Aaron, and unto Eleazar, and unto Ithamar, his sons, uncover not your head, neither rend your clothes, lest ye die.
Don't even mourn. Don't even cry. This his own brother got to say, because this the boss. This who will consume us. You saw how he did your boys. We got to do this right, Aaron. Dog, don't get the crying and tearing your clothes up. Let's just do what thus said the Lord. Go ahead.
And lest wrath come upon all the people.
You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
But let your brethren, the whole house of Israel, bewail the burning which the Lord have kindled.
Plain and simple. So, you know, if somebody telling you, you know, for example, every day is the Sabbath day. I can worship and do what the Lord don't mind. What are you talking about? The Lord said the seventh day he blessed and hallowed. Don't tell me the first day is the Sabbath, and don't tell me every day is the Sabbath. Because if every day was the Sabbath, you wouldn't have your stomach, you perish. You can't eat if you don't work. You can't support your children, and they can't eat if you don't work. You got the work to eat, which he said you got 6 days to do. That's a strange thing for somebody to tell you. So seek ye out of the book. Don't let nobody tell you nothing, and you can't read that thing. Because they got strange doctrine out here. Just like them boys offer strange fire. And the Lord offered good fire for them. Let's go to, where we at?
Leviticus 11.
Let's go to Leviticus 11. Because if somebody telling you that, you know, that the Sabbath ain't the seventh day, They don't care nothing about you. They offering you false instructions, which is can ruin you now and the life to come. Because believe me, the Lord can take you out now and take you out later. Don't think. Cause you got some people thinking just because we gonna die and we gonna we gonna rot and that's it. No, partner. You gonna get rose up, and you gonna spend eternity happily, or you gonna spend it in agony. You choose. Let's look at a simple instruction. And yeah, I'm going here. Do we got to read about swine every week? Yes. Because that's a problem. It's not dietary do's and don'ts. It's a dietary law. It's not a if you feel like it dietary moment. It's a law. And our people are one of the main ones that got a problem with this thing. So let's read it. Let's go right over to the next chapter since we here. We snooping. And we going to pick it up at verse 7. Leviticus 11 and 7. When you get it, brother, go ahead.
And the swine, though he divide the hoof and be cloven-footed, yet he cheweth not the cud, he is unclean to you.
So he divide the hoof. He got an attribute of one of the clean animals, but here's something he don't do. He don't eat the vegetation or the grass, and he don't regurgitate in his mouth and throw it back and eat it again. It's a cycle of how the Lord set that up. Don't ask me. I'm not a scientist. I don't know why the Lord got that like that. But that's what he wants the clean animals doing with that vegetation. The swine don't do that. You slop a swine, or the swine will practically eat whatever he can. They're literally earthly garbage disposals. That's probably what the Lord got them for. Yeah, everything created for some good. Not for you to eat it, though. You can't eat that. He said don't eat it. Go ahead.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
I didn't say that. That wasn't Dominic instruction. That's what we just read. That the Holy Ghost passed down to the prophets via Jesus. And that's what we got to keep. Go ahead.
And their carcass shall ye not touch.
So you can't even touch the dead body unless you're going to be what? Go ahead and finish that, brother.
They are unclean to you.
So if you touch a dead carcass of a swine, you unclean until evening. I understand your job situation. You might work in a slaughterhouse. You might work at a pizza shop. You might got certain things going on. You know, you wear gloves as much as you can, and you just do the best what you can and pray for a better situation. Go ahead and keep reading. Because it ain't just a swine. Keep reading.
These shall ye eat of all that are in the water. Whatsoever have fins and scales in the water, in the seas and in the rivers, them shall ye eat.
So it's okay to eat them that got scales and fins, but not one without the other. Understood? Go ahead.
And all that have not fins and scales in the sea and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters, and of any living thing which is in the waters, they shall be an abomination unto you.
They shall be a satisfaction pleasure unto you. No, it's saying an abomination. A shellfish, a catfish is an abomination. A shrimp, I don't care if they taste good to you, it's an abomination. I can't eat it. You can't eat it. Right. Read some more. Because it don't stop there. Read some more.
They shall be even an abomination unto you. Ye shall not eat of their flesh, but ye shall have their carcasses in abomination.
Is a dead catfish an abomination? Yeah. Go ahead.
Whatsoever hath no fins nor scales in the waters, that shall be an abomination unto you.
Go ahead. Read verse 13. We're going to stop here, but read 13.
And these are they which ye shall have an abomination among the fowls.
So now we got birds that's abominable? Yes. Go ahead.
They shall not be eaten. They are an abomination. The eagle and the ossifrage and the osprey.
Now my advice to you is to go read this thing. Read it out. We ain't going to do all that. But go ahead and read so you can follow some instruction. So you can't say, oh, that guy was just up here saying he wanted to take this from me, and he wanted to say I can't eat this and I can't eat that. And we was raised on duck, and, you know, I'm from the South, and we eat raccoon, and the Lord ain't going to kill me for eating this. Give me Isaiah 66. Let's go right there. I'm not finna play with y'all today. Isaiah 66, and we're going to read how serious this is. People say, well, I stopped eating pork because... you know, it ain't healthy. I know it ain't healthy. Do you know you can eat a piece of shrimp and die? Some people can die from it. So why would you consume something like that? You can die instantly off of. It's a reason why you can die like that. Because it's here for a cleaning service. They follow instructions. The shrimp follow instructions. The catfish follow instructions. You the one, we the one with the problem. Isaiah 66 and verse 15. Will you get it, brother? Go ahead.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by a sword will the Lord plead with all flesh.
Now, this is the Lord, sweet Jesus, who everybody is just, he's just, you know, Mr. Rogers. It's that he coming with. Start it from the top.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind.
Go that fire, go ahead.
To render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
That fire, go ahead.
For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh.
Yep.
And the slain of the Lord shall be many.
Go ahead.
They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree in the midst.
That's Satan the devil. Go ahead.
Eating swine's flesh and the abomination.
We just read some abominations, right? And what else?
And the mouth.
Yeah, they eat that. Go ahead.
Shall be consumed together, saith the Lord.
I'm not saying this, y'all. This instruction that the prophet wrote down via the mouth of the Lord saying that he gonna come and kill you, consume. I know when I consume something, I ate it. So I'm pretty sure the Lord ain't going to eat your fat. But he like that fire. And that fire is consuming. So if that, if them rib tips that good, if your Christmas ham that good, we ain't supposed to do Christmas either. But that's another lesson. If all that stuff is just so enticing to your taste buds and you just can't help yourself, you might as well live it up. Because you going to pay. I'm telling you to do the opposite. I'm telling you to keep the law. So you taking it upon yourself to eat that crap. Well, it's good. I ain't gonna call it crap, but it's crap when you when you kill it and eat it. Because it's an abomination. And it can hurt your temple. That's destroying your temple.
That's right.
Cigarettes and all that ain't good for you, but when you destroying your temple, you going against the law. I can't read smoking cigarettes against the law. Like I said, it's not healthy for you. Where we at, brother?
John 2.
Let's go to John, the second chapter. This sweet G, everybody think Jesus sweet. Like I say, you know, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. He gonna come through, he gonna lay his coat down with his, you know, his pretty blonde hair. He gonna swing it to the side. And he gonna pass out, you know, gift baskets and take everybody up to heaven. And we gonna sing and kumbaya, and nobody evil gotta pay for nothing they did, because he love everybody. And that's not the case. It's virtually impossible for that to be the case. If we read in context, let's read how upset Jesus can get. Second John verse 2. Chapter 2, verse 13. Go ahead.
You want John 2?
John 2. Yeah, I'm sorry, brother. Verse 13. When you get it, go ahead, brother.
And the Jews' Passover was at hand.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus went up to Jerusalem
and
found in the temple those that sold oxen and sheep and doves and the changers of money sitting.
Yeah.
And when he had made a scourge of small cords.
So the Lord got mad and made a whip. Nice cuddly Jesus sitting up here thinking about how he finna put some pain on somebody. Go ahead.
He drove them all out of the temple and the sheep and the oxen and poured out the changers' money and overthrew the table and said unto them that sold doves, take these things hence. Make not my father's house a house of merchandise.
Because the Lord followed instruction. He was the instruction giver, and he got him and his dad conjured up how he was going to come down and teach us to do it. Go ahead.
And his disciples remembered that it was written, the zeal of thine house have eaten me up.
So this sweet Jesus now, Let's go to Matthew the 4. Matthew, you got it. It's a typo on there. It's my fault, though. I'm sorry about that, Brother Aaron, Brother Rich. It's actually Matthew 10 and 14. I ain't trying to mess up y'all program this week. I apologize. That was on me. Like I said, you know, if somebody want to disrupt the word of God that you're trying to give out, you let them be disruptive. If they just not going to hear, because the book say whether they will hear, whether they will forbear, right?
That's right.
You can do what you can do. That's it. That's all you can do. When I came into the thing, I was trying to shove it down their throat because I know what the end outcome could be for people. So I was hurt by that, but I had to calm down. And I had to come to my elder and be like, man, is this right, this wrong? Holler at the elders, you know? And they let me know, man, look, you got to take it down a notch. You got to calm down and come at these people a couple of times and let it go. Because the word don't go out void or vain. Matthew 10 and 14. It say 4 on your program, but it's verse 14. Matthew 10 and 14. Go ahead.
And whosoever shall not receive you,
mm-hmm.
nor hear your words, when you depart out of that house or city,
yep.
shake off the dust of your feet.
So if you come with instruction and ain't nobody trying to hear you, move around. Get the bad vibes up off you and on to the next. Don't waste no more time there. The Lord wants you to go. Abort that. Get up out of there. Let's go to Titus, the 3rd chapter. Hit some pages. Titus 3, and pick it up at verse 1. You get it, Brother Real? Go ahead.
Put them in mind to be subject to principalities and powers,
mm-hmm.
to obey magistrates,
mm-hmm.
to be ready to every good work,
yeah.
to speak evil of no man,
mm-hmm.
to be no brawlers, but gentle, showing all meekness unto all men.
Instructions, right? Go ahead.
For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish.
Yes, we was. Don't deny that. Don't do it and say you wasn't. Go ahead.
Disobedient.
Yep.
Deceived.
Uh-huh.
Serving diverse lusts
yep.
and pleasures.
Yeah.
Living in malice and envy.
Yep.
Hateful and hating one another.
Yes, we were, but we got instruction now that we got to love our neighbor, right? And we got to love the Lord God with all our mind and our soul, right?
That's right.
So we can't live like that. We can't do that. Go ahead.
But after that, the kindness and love of God, our Savior, toward man appeared.
Mm-hmm.
Not by works of righteousness, which we have done,
mm-hmm.
but according to his mercy, he saved us.
Mm-hmm.
But a washing of regeneration mm-hmm. and renewing of the Holy Ghost.
So that's how he saved you. You ain't saved from we ain't had the great tribulation. Ain't nobody made the first resurrection. He talking about he saved you by giving you instruction and by the washing and regeneration and renewing the Holy Ghost. So through this word being distributed to the people and to them keeping the word, that's how you got a shot at being saved later in the latter days. Go ahead.
Which he shed on us abundantly through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
That's right.
That being justified by his grace,
mm-hmm.
we should be made heirs according to the hope of eternal life.
Go ahead.
This is a faithful saying, and these things I will that thou affirm constantly, that they which have believed in God might be careful
mm-hmm.
to maintain good works.
Yeah.
These things are good and profitable unto men.
So if you keep an instruction and good works, you gotta maintain that thing. It's easy to fall off. It's easy to go astray. But the maintenance part of it, it's a big part. Because the walk... The commandments is not hard or they not grievous. It's just the world make this thing hard. You know, now, you know, if a homosexual get into a cab and want to talk about wicked things, the cab driver just got to shut his mouth and look forward. Because if he say something to offend or make the homosexual upset, then the world look at him wicked. When it's the total opposite way around.
That's right.
How the kingdom operate. Go ahead.
But avoid foolish questions.
Yes.
And genealogy.
Yep.
And contentions.
Mm-hmm.
And strivings about the law.
Right.
For they are unprofitable and vain.
Go ahead.
A man that is an heretic after the first and second admonition reject.
If he, like I said, one or two times, if he don't want no instruction, he want to be disruptive and interrupt, let him move around. You ain't got time for that. Because you're trying to keep yourself in check, right? You're trying to keep your foot out the lake of fire, right? Better yet, being submerged in it, right? Let's go to Ezekiel 2. We almost out of here. I see how y'all looking. We almost out of here. I got you. Now, y'all some beautiful people. Praise God. All right, Ezekiel 2, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Make sure I'm on here, because Brother Jarrell, he got it all together. Let me make sure I got me together. So this is one, this is it on y'all program? Mm-hmm. Okay, all right, I didn't have myself together, so, but we got it here, we good. All right, so Ezekiel 2, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. When you get it, brother, go ahead.
And he said unto me, Son of man, stand upon thy feet, and I will speak unto thee.
Mm-hmm.
And the Spirit entered into me when he spake unto me, and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that spake unto me.
Uh-huh.
And he said unto me, Son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel, to a rebellious nation that have rebelled against me.
To a wonderful listening nation. No, he said a rebellious nation that rebelled against me. I'm going to send you to them. Go ahead.
They and their fathers have transgressed against me, even unto this very day.
Yeah.
For they are impudent children and stiff-hearted.
Y'all know me, y'all. Go ahead.
I do send thee unto them, and thou shalt say unto them, Thus saith the Lord God. And they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are a rebellious house, yet shall know that there have been a prophet among them.
And so he's saying whether they're going to listen to you or whether they not, don't worry about that. You just give them the instructions, which I'm going to tell what I got for you to get to them. Go ahead.
And thou, son of man, be not afraid of them, neither be afraid of their words.
Yeah, because, you know, Israel got some words. You'll get cussed out trying to tell somebody something. Go ahead.
Though briars and thorns be with thee, and thou dost dwell among scorpions, be not afraid of their words, nor be dismayed at their looks, though they be a rebellious house.
Go ahead.
And thou shalt speak my words unto them.
So he didn't say speak your words, Ezekiel. He said speak mine. Go ahead.
Whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are most rebellious.
So, no problem. Easy peasy, right? You just get it out there. Whether they won't hear, whether they're going to forbear, that's up to them. Let's go to 2 Kings. Because we said earlier how we should let the Lord handle things, even when we give out instruction. You still got to wait on the Lord, because we can get carried away.
That's right.
Hey, you know. First Samuel 25, and we're going to do a little reading here. Second Kings, I'm sorry. That's my fault. Second Kings. And we're going to pick it up verse 2. I didn't jump the gun. So Second Kings chapter 2. And we're going to pick it up in verse 23. When you get it, Brother Real, go ahead.
And he went up from thence unto Bethel. And as he was going up by the way, there came forth little children out of the city and mocked him and said unto him, Go up, thou bald head. Go up, thou bald head. And he turned back and looked on them and cursed them in the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord. So this is one of the Lord's prophets that did some miracles. And these are children that's mocking the man. So I will be careful on how I teach my kids to respect folk. Mm. Go ahead.
And there came forth two she-bears out of the wood and tear 40 and two children of them.
Mm. So that's something to think about. So you got to be leery of the Lord's instructors as well. Now we can go to 1 Samuel. Let me slow down. I was trying to get y'all up out of here. Let me slow down. Let me take it down a notch. We got plenty of time. So 1 Samuel 25. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Go ahead, Brother Real.
And Samuel died. And all the Israelites were gathered together and lamented him and buried him in his house at Ramah. And David arose and went down to the wilderness of Paran. And there was a man in Maon whose possessions were in Carmel. And the man was very great.
Meaning he had a lot of stuff. He wasn't a man of renown and knowledge. He had a lot of possession. Go ahead.
And he had 3,000 sheep and 1,000 goats. And he was shearing his sheep in Carmel. Now the name of the man was Nabal. And the name of his wife, Abigail. And she was a woman of good understanding and of a beautiful countenance.
So what did it say first she was, though?
Good understanding.
And that just wasn't, you know, worldly and moral. She had some understanding of the Lord, too. Go ahead.
But the man was churlish and evil in his doings, and he was of the house of Caleb.
So she had an evil husband, but she had understanding. So that goes to show you that you can still be severed and sanctified from your spouse in the eyes of the Lord as far as doing his word. Y'all together, worldly, because you made a, you know, you made a decision, but in the eyes of the Lord, one could be good, one could be evil. We just saw it. Go ahead.
And David heard in the wilderness that Nabal did shear sheep.
Yeah.
And David sent out 10 young men. And David said unto the young men, get you up to Carmel and go to Nabal and greet him in my name.
Yeah.
And thus shall ye say to him that liveth in prosperity, peace be both to thee and peace be to thine house and peace be unto all that thou hast.
So he said in a nice message, man, peace to you, peace to everything you got going on. I see you shining. Everything all good, man. Go ahead.
And now I have heard that thou hast shears. Now thy shepherds which were with us, we hurt them not. Neither was there aught missing unto them all the while they were in Carmel.
So he's saying, look, man, we was out here on the same area they was at. We ain't rob them. We could have took everything. We could have killed them. We could have did what we want. We Israel. This we represent. We really move how we want. Long as it's in righteousness. And if we was hungry, we could have took y'all stuff. But we didn't. We looked out for y'all. Go ahead.
Ask thy young men, and they will show thee. Wherefore, let the young men find favor in thine eyes. For we come in a good day. Give, I pray thee, whatsoever cometh to thine hand unto thy servants and to thy son David.
Go ahead.
And when David's young men came, they spake to Nabal according to all those words in the name of David and ceased. And Nabal answered David's servants and said,
now check out what he got to say. Go ahead.
Who is David?
Now you know who he is, but go ahead.
And who is the son of Jesse?
Now you know, we know you know because you know his daddy. Go ahead.
There be many servants nowadays that break away every man from his master. Shall I then take my bread and my water and my flesh that I have killed for my shears and give it unto men whom I know not whence they be?
Bad decision, buddy. Go ahead.
So David's young men turned their way and went again and came and told him all those sayings.
Now, I don't know if they knew, if you really knew how David get down, but you coming to tell a righteous brother, but he's a straight killer. Yep. This the message he receiving back. Go ahead.
And David said unto his men, gird ye on every man his sword. And they girded on every man his sword. And David also girded on his sword. And there went up after David about 400 men and 200 abode by the stuff.
So he said, you know what? He rang the bell. Come on, y'all know what time it is, man. Let's ride. Come on. Let's go. Ain't nothing to talk about. Grab the thumpers. Let's go. Go ahead.
But one of the young men told Abigail, Nabal's wife, saying, behold, David sent messengers out of the wilderness to salute our master, and he railed on them. But the men were very good unto us, and we were not hurt, neither missed we anything, as long as we were conversing with them when we were in the field. They were a wall unto us both by night and day. All the while we were with them keeping the sheep. Now therefore, know and consider what thou wilt do. For evil is determined against our master and against all his household. For he is such a son of Belial that a man cannot speak to him.
Because you got some people out here like that you can't even talk to. You can't have a comment. You can't even say hi or bye or how you doing. How was your day? What you got planned for the evening? You can't say nothing. They don't want to hear it. Or they got something wicked or negative to say or something to bring you down. Go ahead.
Then Abigail made haste and took 200 loaves and 2 bottles of wine and 5 sheep ready dressed.
Did she say anything out her mouth after she received this information? Nope. You see the two different type of people her husband was? Her husband was popped off, got out his body, said all type of stuff he shouldn't have said. I ain't going to say probably, but what the woman do? Straight to the business. Go ahead.
And 5 measures of parched corn.
Yeah.
And 100 clusters of raisins.
Yeah.
And 200 cakes of figs.
Yeah.
And laid them on asses.
Uh-huh.
And she said unto her servants, go on before me. Behold, I come after you.
Yeah.
But she told not her husband, Nabal.
Uh-huh.
And it was so. And she rode on the ass, and she came down by the covert of the hill. And behold, David and his men came down against her, and she met them.
Uh-huh.
Now David had said, surely in vain have I kept all that this fellow hath in the wilderness, so that nothing was missed of all that pertained unto him.
Mm-hmm.
And he hath requited me evil for good.
Because he did. Go ahead.
So and more also do God unto the enemies of David.
Mm-hmm.
If I leave of all that pertain to him by the morning light, any that pisseth against the wall.
So he said, man, look, don't worry about it. Ain't finna be nothing that can take a leak against the wall that's gonna be living by the morning. Because that's how David got down. They say, well, Saul killed thousands, but David killed 10,000. Go ahead.
And when Abigail saw David, she hasted and lighted off the ass and fell before David on her face and bowed herself to the ground and fell at his feet and said, upon me, my Lord, upon me let this iniquity be.
Now, this is a strange woman. With this knowledge like this, with this humble, meek heart like this. Go ahead.
And let thine handmaid, I pray thee, speak in thine audience
mm-hmm.
and hear the words of thine handmaid.
Uh-huh.
Let not my Lord, I pray thee, regard this man of Belial, even Nabal. For as his name is, so is he.
Uh-huh.
Nabal is his name and folly is with
him. She just kept it real with him. Like, look, my husband, he's a folly character. He'll get us all killed. Look, I respect you as a king. I know what you into. I know who your God is. Go ahead.
But I, thine handmaid, saw not the young man of my Lord whom thou didst send.
Mm-hmm.
Now therefore, my Lord, as the Lord liveth and as thy soul liveth, seeing the Lord have withholden thee from coming to shed blood and from avenging thyself with thine own hand,
mm-hmm.
now let thine enemies and they that seek evil to my Lord be as Nabal.
Mm-hmm.
And now this blessing which thine handmaid have brought unto my Lord, let it even be given unto the young man that follow my Lord.
Now you see how she's speaking this thing into existence because she's trying to say this. She's trying to save her people. And I commend her for it. Go ahead.
I pray thee, forgive the trespass of thine handmaid.
Uh-huh.
For the Lord will certainly make my Lord a sure house.
Uh-huh.
Because my Lord fighteth the battles of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And evil have not been found in thee all thy days.
Yep.
Yet a man is risen to pursue thee and to seek thy soul.
Yep.
But the soul of my Lord shall be bound in the bundle of life with the Lord thy God.
Mm.
And the souls of thy enemies, them shall he sling out as out of the middle of a sling.
Go ahead.
And it shall come to pass, when the Lord have done to my Lord according to all the good that he has spoken concerning thee, and shall have appointed thee ruler over Israel.
So she already know what's going to happen. Then it say she get, what's the first thing it said about her attributes? She good had good understanding.
That's right.
Go ahead.
That this shall be no grief unto thee, no offense of heart unto my Lord.
She talking her way out this thing. Go ahead.
Either that thou hast shed blood causeless, or that my Lord hath avenged himself.
Mm-hmm.
But when the Lord shall have dealt well with my Lord, then remember thine handmaid.
Mm-hmm.
And David said to Abigail, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, which sent thee this day to meet me.
Uh-huh.
And blessed be thy advice, and blessed be thou, which have kept me this day from coming to shed blood.
But that's what he came to do. Go ahead.
And from avenging myself with mine own hand.
Yep.
For in very deed, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, which have kept me back from hurting thee, except thou hadst hasted and come to meet me, surely there had not been left unto Nabal by the morning light any that pisseth against the wall.
Go ahead.
So David received of her hand that which she had brought him and said unto her, go up in peace to thine house. See, I have hearkened to thy voice and have accepted thy person.
So he followed that instruction and he listened. Go ahead.
And Abigail came to Nabal, and behold, he held a feast in his house.
Oh, he up here chilling. He up here kicking it. Go ahead.
Like the feast of a king.
Go ahead.
And Nabal's heart was merry within him, for he was very drunken.
Yep.
Wherefore, she told him nothing less or more until the morning light.
Probably want to blow his high, because he was just finna get whacked. He was done. Go ahead.
But it came to pass in the morning, when the wine was gone out of Nabal, and his wife had told him these things, that his heart died within him, and he became as a stone.
What a feeling. Go ahead.
And it came to pass about 10 days after that the Lord smote Nabal that he died.
So the Lord took care of that. David ain't have to. Go ahead.
And when David heard that Nabal was dead, he said, blessed be the Lord that hath pleaded the cause of my reproach from the hand of Nabal and have kept his servant from evil. For the Lord hath returned the wickedness of Nabal upon his own head.
Yep.
And David sent and communed with Abigail to take her to him to wife.
He ain't take her before. He could have, after she bought stuff, he could have come. He followed instruction, though. He knew he couldn't, you know, even though he fell short on that later, but he followed instruction. Go ahead.
And when the servants of David will come to Abigail to Carmel, they spake unto her, saying, David sent us unto thee to take thee to him to wife. And she arose and bowed herself on her face to the earth and said, behold, let thine handmaid be a servant to wash the feet of the servants of my Lord.
Now she done came upon her king. She's straight. Go ahead.
And Abigail hasted and arose and rode upon an ass with five damsels of hers that went after her. And she went after the messengers of David and became his wife.
So she done got promoted. David done got a good woman to understand it, all from just following instruction, not being quick to pop off. Go ahead.
David also took Ahinoam of Jezreel, and they were also both of them his wives.
Okay, we can stop right there. Let's go to Matthew, the 26th chapter. And we got one more after that, and I'm going to get y'all out of here. Because even Jesus himself, the Lord himself kept instruction. So don't tell me you ain't got to do something, or you on a different dispensation, or all this stuff they got to say. The Lord himself kept the instruction of his own execution. Let's read Matthew 26 and verse 31. When you get it, brother, go ahead.
Then said Jesus unto them, all ye shall be offended because of me this night. For it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock shall be scattered abroad.
Skip down to verse 36.
Then cometh Jesus with them unto a place called Gethsemane, and saith unto the disciples, sit ye here while I go and pray yonder. And he took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and began to be sorrowful and very heavy.
Because the Lord knew this thing had to go down. He knew he had to die for the sins of man to give us a shot at back, getting back right with his Father. So he worried. Any man would be worried. Any entity would be worried if they knew that they was finna go through something with the Lord. Go ahead.
Then saith he unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me.
Yeah.
And he went a little farther and fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh, my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt.
Now, I accept that what the Lord said. He ain't trying to get out of instruction. He just said, Lord, look, if this thing could get, if I can get up out this jam and still be right with you, then so be it. If not, then let it go. Go ahead.
And he cometh unto the disciples and findeth them asleep and saith unto Peter, what? Could ye not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And that's what happens. Y'all know what I'm talking about. This flesh is weak. Go ahead.
He went away again the second time and prayed, saying, oh, my Father, if this cup may not pass away from me, except I drink it, thy will be done.
Now, he got death on the table. And like I said before, you know, we be worried about our bills getting paid and, being accepted to a certain criteria, a crowd of people, and what people think about. This man finna lose his life, and he gonna follow instruction and carry it out to the T. Just what if you woke up this morning at 8 o'clock and you knew you was finna die by 3? You knew it was inevitable, it was gonna happen. And you had to go through a procedure to get to that. Could you carry it out? That's all I'm asking. Skip down to, and this is God himself. Skip down to verse 50.
And Jesus said unto him, Friend, wherefore art thou come? Then came they and laid hands on Jesus and took him.
Uh-huh.
And behold, one of them which were with Jesus stretched out his hand and drew his sword and struck a servant of the high priest and smote off his ear.
He ain't had no instruction to do that. The Lord ain't telling him to do that. And I appreciate his zeal, but he ain't following instructions. Go ahead.
Then said Jesus unto him, Put up again thy sword into his place. For all they that take the sword shall perish with the sword.
So he did something overly good. He cut somebody ear off. He said, no, don't do that. Don't worry about that. Because those who do that, y'all, that's how y'all end gonna be. Go ahead.
Thinkest thou that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels?
So he said, man, I don't need that. I got to go through with this instruction. This was planned. I can't interrupt this thing. My Father, what, one legion is what, 2,000 or something like that or more? He said he can send 12 legions of them. So that's over 24,000. And one of them killed almost 200,000 in one night. So I don't need nothing. I got to do this thing. Me and my Father made a covenant, and I got to carry this thing out. Go ahead.
But how then shall the scriptures be fulfilled that thus it must be?
So now, the Lord had to follow instructions unto death. Read the rest of that chapter out, and you will see how the Lord was executed and how he didn't twitch and how he didn't. He went on like a goat walking in to get killed. And they don't even know what's going on. That's how the Lord went in. We got one more scripture here. Proverbs. The 8th chapter. And we're going to pick it up in verse 33. Proverbs 8 and verse 33. When you get it, Brother Real, go ahead.
Hear instruction and be wise.
Yeah.
And refuse it not.
Yep.
Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gate, waiting at the pulse of my door.
Yeah.
For whoso findeth me findeth life.
Yeah.
And shall obtain favor of the Lord.
Yep.
But he that sinneth against me wrongeth his own soul.
Mm-hmm.
All they that hate me love death.
Is that understood? Is that plain and simple? Nipped in the bud? It say, hear instruction and be wise. Because if you hear an instruction, that makes you intelligent. Just simple instruction. I don't care what it is. That make you intelligent. In this life here, and when the Lord come back, it's still going to be instruction. You know what? Let's go read that. And that'll be last. I'm sorry, it ain't on your program. I added it, though. Isaiah 66. And we out of here, y'all. This will be last. Isaiah 66. And pick it up at verse 20. When you get it, Brother Rail. Go ahead.
And they shall bring all your brethren for an offering unto the Lord out of all nations upon horses and in chariots and in litters and upon mules and upon swift beasts to my holy mountain Jerusalem, saith the Lord, as the children of Israel bring an offering in a clean vessel into the house of the Lord. And I will also take of them for priests and for Levites, saith the Lord.
Yeah.
For as the new heavens and the new earth, which I will make, shall remain before me, saith the Lord, so shall your seed and your name remain. And it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, saith the Lord.
Yep.
And they shall go forth and look upon the carcasses of the men that are transgressed against me. For their worms shall not die, neither shall their fire be quenched, and they shall be an abhorrence unto all flesh.
So it's still going to be instruction to follow, period, even at the coming of the Lord. That's why he going to have us going up there. He going to have some Levites. He going to institute that again, you know. So just hold on to where your friend is. I mean, I ain't keeping you from doing it, but the Lord going to set this up again. and we still gonna have to follow instructions no matter what. After the Father come down, who knows? So that's the lesson. The instruction of the Lord should not be interrupted. I hope somebody got some understanding. I thank you for your time. And now we got today's announcement.
We'd like to welcome all our brothers and sisters to the Church of Israel, and we hope you come worship with us again. Our weekly Bible class starts at 11 a.m. Central Time every Sabbath. Bible question and answer starts at 2 p.m. every Sabbath. Internet members will be able to ask questions via live YouTube streaming. We have a children's class for ages 4 through 14. Parents with children under the age of 4 must be with their children in the children's room during class. We will be having a service and baptism in Atlanta, Georgia on December 14th at 1 p.m. Contact the church for the location if you are interested in being baptized. We are planning for a service and baptism in North Carolina in mid-January 2020. If you would like to attend or get baptized, please update your contact information via the membership form on our website or by email. The Church of Israel has a Bryan, Texas Bible study class located at 1909 South College, Bryan, Texas. The Church of Israel has a Houston, Texas Bible study class located at the Days Inn by Wyndham, 10650 Huffmeister Road, Houston, Texas. The Church of Israel has a Jamaican Bible study class located in Portmore, Jamaica. Please contact the church for additional information. The Church of Israel has a Norfolk, Virginia Bible study class located at the Jordan Newby Anchor Branch Library, 1425 Northchester Avenue, Norfolk, Virginia, which meets every other Sabbath. Please contact the church for the dates. The Church of Israel's Chicago cable TV program airing on Comcast Channel 36 every Friday evening at 8 p.m. and Monday mornings at 10 a.m. The weekly Bible lessons are now being sent out via our own email service, nonreply@thechurchofisrael.com. All email addresses have been taken off the membership forms completed on the internet. We ask that all regular members please remember to bring your own Bible and scarves every Sabbath. The Bible and scarves we provide are for visitors and new members. If you use or see a Bible or scarf provided by the Church of Israel, please return it to the shelf prior to leaving. Free CDs of today's lesson will be available next week. We ask that everyone support the audio and video ministry with donations when you fill out your tithe envelope and help pay for the free CDs and DVDs we provide to the congregation and others that request them. If you are parked in the center of the parking lot or blocking anyone in, please move your car immediately after class to let others out. There is no eating in the sanctuary. All food and drinks except water are to be consumed in the kitchen area only. Parents, please keep your children with you in the lounge after class. No children should be in the sanctuary or parking lot without their parents. The Church of Israel has a dress code. Brothers, please remove any head covering upon entering the building. Do not wear sleeveless shirts, shorts, sagging, tight-fitting, fleece or jogging pants, or any other revealing pants. Sisters, please have a head covering. This is required. Hat, scarf, etc. For all girls and women, do not wear pants, shorts, mini dresses, halter tops of any kind, revealing splits, tight-fitting or cleavage-revealing attire, modest apparel only. These are today's announcements.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Our Father, which art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
Thine will be done.
In earth.
In earth.
As it is in heaven.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day.
Give us this day.
Our daily bread.
Our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts.
And forgive us our debts.
As we forgive our debtors.
As we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not.
And lead us not.
Into temptation.
Into temptation.
But deliver us.
But deliver us.
From evil.
From evil.
For thine is the kingdom. kingdom.
For thine is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the power.
And the glory.
And the glory.
Forever.
Forever.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord God of Israel.
Praise the Lord God of Israel.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Boy, I know y'all.
Nah, because it's ripping the page.